हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम अगेन बैक विद अ न्यू सीरीज ऑफ वीडियो हाउ टू अप्रोच अ डिफरेंट केस इन द मेडिसिन फॉर योर प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, फॉर योर क्लिनिकल एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू और फॉर योर वाइवा पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सो स्टे ट्यून विद द वीडियो एंड वॉच टिल द एंड, सो यू मे फाइंड इट ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड हाउ टू अप्रोच अ केस ऑफ डायरिया स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो इवेल्यूट द केस विद द डिफरेंट मोडालिटी एंड ट्रीट द केस डिपेंड ऑन कोर्स. So stay tuned with the video and this is our first case. So we will discuss the case and after that on the basis of case we will evaluate the symptoms and discuss the modalities of treatment also. So a 1 year old girl is brought to a clinic with 3 days complaint of watery brown diarrhea and vomiting and also irritability presents. On examination of the child found that the child is a lethargic, febrile with sunken eyes and weak pulse of 150 per minute. And what is the best management for the child and how to the evaluate the case of diarrhea for this child. So for a 1 year child there is the common infectious agent like virus, there is the rotavirus is the common for a child, and there is the bacteria, parasitic and toxins also present. So in the 1 year child you may find there is the rotaviral infections. For the bacteria there is the Salmonella or Escherichia coli or Campylobacterial species is the common agent for the diarrhea causing in the child. In the parasitic you may find the Escherichia or Giardia, and the toxins you may find Clostridium difficile, Staphylococcus aureus or any food poisoning for the child. So child is the presenting with the Staphylococcus aureus or Bacillus cereus toxin for the food poisoning case. So here is the different agent for producing non-bloody diarrhea or the bloody diarrhea. Okay, so you have to evaluate the presence of blood in the stools or non-presence of blood in the stools. So how to evaluate the acute case of diarrhea? So I have made a flow chart for you guys. So from the flow chart we can go step by step to understand what is the important and main cause for this patient and how to treat. So from the acute diarrhea, like the less than 3 days or less than 6-7 days for the week present in the called as the acute diarrhea, or more than 14 days we called as the chronic diarrhea. From the history and physical examination point of view we found that the child is the lethargic, pulse rate is the increase 150 per minute, and the physical examination point the consistency of stool, blood present in the stools, what is the frequency of stools, is there any sticky discharge or any thin consistency. So these important points we have to evaluate, and from that we can find okay, so there is the likely of non-infectious cause or non-infectious cause. So there is two options we have, so from that we have to evaluate. So non-infectious cause, so from that we can go to the non-infectious causes first and evaluate the case. So from non-infectious cause you may find the drug induced diarrhea or any food poisoning, so we have to stop the drug or stop the food contaminated to child have eaten, and the diarrhea will be resolved with the treatment. So we have to just institute fluid and electrolyte replacement for this child which is a non-infectious causes, so we don't have to worry. But main important is the infectious causes which I have discussed, the bacterial, parasitical, virus or any toxin produced by the infectious agent. So from that we classify the diarrhea into three types: mild, moderate or severe. Okay, so there is three modality available in us. So there is three classification. The child is which is classification? The child may found this, there is the mild diarrhea, like the less than 5 times in a day. So example we count as a mild. So for that mild cases we have to just replace the fluid and electrolyte for the child. So from the electrolyte and fluid replacement we can observe the further evaluation of the child and examine that vitals of the child is improving or not. If it is improving, so continue with the same fluid and electrolyte replacement according to child need. Okay, so if the child is not improving by that, so we have to monitor the child and we have to culture the stool sample and send the sample of stool to microbiology lab for diagnosis of the specific organisms which causing the diarrhea in these patients. Okay, so let's come to the moderate variety. For the moderate variety we also starting the same treatment, institute of fluid and electrolyte replacement for the same. And in the severe type we also presenting the same modality of treatment, fluid and electrolyte replacement. But in the moderate cases either activities is altered, or in the severe diarrhea child is on full lethargic, blood pressure is increased, अल्टर सेंसोरियम और डिहाइड्रेटेड स्टेट, शंकन आइज, मोस्ट सिम्टम्स प्रेजेंट इन दिस मॉडरेट टू सीवियर केसेस. सो वी हैव टू मॉनिटर चाइल्ड केयरफुली. इफ देर इज अ फीवर प्रेजेंट मोर देन 38.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस और एनी ब्लडी स्टूल्स प्रेजेंट, ब्लड इन डायरिया और फिकल आरबीसीज और एनी पस इन द ब्लड और चाइल्ड इज द इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज स्टेट और इज द एल्डरली होस्ट. सो वी हैव टू नो दिस features that in this one of the category child is coming or in the old host like more than 60 year old female or more male he came to the hospital with the complaints of bloody diarrhea. So we have to evaluate if there is in institute of blood institute of fluid and electrolytes, if patient is improving but there is no any associated features, so we have to start with anti diarrheal agents like anti motility, anti secretory. So if one because of that, if the patient is improving, so we have to just continue the same therapy and maintain the electrolyte balance with the patient. Okay, if the patient is not improving and he has not any associated complaint, so we have to also take a stool sample for microbiology samples, and also we have to check specific pathogens for the child. So from that we can identify the pathogen and we can go about the antibiotic therapy. If the associated complaint present in the patients, so we found that the patient is the associated with complaint, so we take a stool sample and send to microbiology department to evaluate the stool sample and associated organisms identification, so we can start the associated specific organism based antibiotic therapy. If the organism is found, so we have to select specific antibiotic therapy which is sensitive to organisms, and if the organism is not found, if pathogen is not found, if the bacteria, parasite or any organism not found, we have to start empirical treatment based on patient's symptoms and signs and associated features, and further evaluation is done, patient history, deep history, detailed history taken, or any food history or any patient's associated with features, we have to take and we have to evaluate, oh this is the cause of the diarrhea, so we have to evaluate the step one by one. So now move to the therapy. So what is the therapy goal we have to institute for the patients? From the man, we have to understand that there is a mild case or moderate case of diarrhea. We have to just replace the fluid and electrolyte imbalance which is deficit to child, because in the small child or neonates we found that the child is losing weight, so we have to just confirm the deficit of the child fluid and we have to replace by fluid replacement therapy is the known as the ORS solutions generally recommended by WHO. So ORS solution is the given in these compositions, and in the some patient is the ORS is also not adequate, so we have to reduce the osmolarity and we have to give reduce osmolarity ORS, so both will be given as much as child needed. According to child need, we have to deliver the ORS solution and we have to just replace the electrolyte and fluid replacement and deliver the fluid so patient relieved by the dehydration features and alter sensorium and lethargic features and improving the blood pressure and decreases the pulse in this patient. So what is the treatment, specific treatments for the pharmacological therapy? We can know that there is the drugs available like anti-motility drugs, absorption, anti-secretory drugs like glycopyrrolate, antibiotic on the basis of bacteria, parasite or virus, we have to just take care like the antibiotic we giving the ciprofloxacin tablets or enzymes or intestinal microflora for the lactobacillus we can giving to improve the patient's complaint and the relieve the patient to from the diarrhea. So from this treatment we can give, or in the small child we are generally found that the zinc is the also working in this patient, so we also give the zinc supplements for 14 days to small child, so child may relieve by the symptoms of diarrhea and child may recover from the treatment. So this is the available treatment therapy for the diarrhea cases. So this is the important flow chart you have to understand and learn one by one steps. So you can take this chart from my bio and I also will put into my channel, so you can download from it and you can understand step by step, and this is the treatment modality available for the diarrhea patients. So stay tuned with your video and I will discuss the next important cases like headache, fever, abdominal pain, vomiting, constipations. Also I will discuss for the Viva point of view and medicine केस डिस्कशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, आई विल टेक केयर ऑफ इट, सो डोंट वरी, जस्ट स्टे ट्यून विद द वीडियो एंड वॉच टिल देन, सो यू मे फाइंड इट ईजी. सो होप यू गाइस आर एंजॉइंग विद द केस. सो दिस इज अवर टूडेज केस फॉर डायरिया. थैंक यू सो मच गाइस. इफ यू लाइक अवर एफर्ट्स, शेयर, सब्सक्राइब एंड लाइक अवर वीडियो.